So I chose Beloit.
I chose Beloit College.
So the reason I chose Beloit.
So I chose Beloit because.
I chose Beloit because.
I chose Beloit because of the respect and warmth I felt from the team when I came in here as a recruit and from Coach George. I knew I'd be treated well as a person and the culture I wanted to be a part of.
Mostly because of Coach George, you know, during my recruiting process.
He was actually the most consistent coach out of all the coaches in terms of calling me all the time and, like, pretty much making me feel wanted. And, like, I really feel like I got to know Coach Dave really well. And so he really made me comfortable with the decision to come here. And really, I believed everything he was saying. And everything he did say to me about how great of a school it is, how great of an experience I'll have, it was all true.
Called me all the time, constantly asking me how I'm doing. It was more than just like, oh, hey, I want you to play baseball. It was more like, I want you to get a good education. This is also the place for that.
Something that really drew me here was obviously, like a lot of the other guys said, Coach George. All the guys on the team know he was mostly the most consistent out of the coaches that contacted people. He always would call you, see how you're doing. If you had any questions, he was there. He definitely made me feel like I was part of the team.
I'm going to start with my class. I live with all of them. That should say something about how close we all are. Like, they're friends for life. And
it was nice to have these guys, like, by my side throughout it all, you know, like.
Probably it's just the younger guys, I feel, have been pretty good. I drove back to California my sophomore year with Cam Salih, who was a freshman at the time. And then junior year, I drove back with Mark Christine and Steve O'Neill, who were also, were freshmen at the time. And so I feel like I've got to know the underclassmen pretty well. It wasn't a big junior class, but they're a big sophomore and freshman class.
The diversity of people throughout the country and the world, because in terms of on the team, we got guys from California, New Mexico, like Massachusetts, like all over the country. And just meeting the diversity of people and just seeing how we can come together and be one. Like, I've learned to build relationships with all types of people.
Chemistry. Team chemistry was the biggest difference between this year and every other year. I feel like some of the other years, you know, obviously I got along with the guys on the team, but, you know, playing wasn't always necessarily the same kind of feel that we had this year, whereas now we just have to play big people, weird people together, just having fun playing baseball and playing, you know, really carefree, and that's the biggest difference for us.
What separates us from other teams is that even though us as seniors might say stuff that guys don't agree with, guys seem to be able to accept it, and even if they don't like it, they're quiet and they put the team ahead of themselves. And while that's like easy to say, like everyone says, oh yeah, I put the team ahead of myself, it's really hard to do, especially at this level.
When I hit the walk-off, I had a walk-off single in Florida. That was a really cool experience. I was glad to have that opportunity. But, I mean, nothing can beat winning a conference championship at all times. Just being in that dog pile, taking pictures, holding the trophy, just being crazy. It's my favorite thing.
It's only been, like, not even a day left later, but, like, how we won the championship and then, like, I graduated, like, less than 24 hours later. So, like, it was just, like, it's been crazy. Like, it still hasn't even sunk in yet. Because it was, like, we won it, and it all went so fast.
Well, the conference championship, obviously, was, like, great and extremely rewarding. But I'm going to actually go with the day before that. The win to get to the conference championship was playing St. Norbert, because they're one of our rivals, and they beat up on us, you know, all the time. And I just felt like, you know, we've just been taking it for so long. And then finally, we beat them in the regular season. We beat them in extra innings to go to the conference championship. And the feeling was just indescribable. And when I was rounding third and Ryan Kaveney again hit me in, just slapping the plate and charging, like, everybody on the field and just being there with my teammates, like my lifelong friends, that was just, like, that's I'll never forget that game, ever.
So many great memories from this year. From even starting in Florida, we had that walk-off. We had, like I said, Ryan hitting that home. We've just had special moments all year. And, I imagine once I look back at it, it's going to be just amazing, especially this last weekend winning conferences. Something that we've dreamed about for 4 years and we finally did it.
Ryan is a legend.
Ryan's a beast.
Ryan's a big weirdo.
Me and Ryan are best buds.
Yeah, so Ryan Kaveney is my best friend. I love that guy. Everybody loves that guy.
Every time he's on the mound, we feel like we're going to win.
I remember going back to freshman week. If you know Ryan, you know, when you just meet him, he's not really always the most talkative guy. But we kind of brought him in freshman week, and he was hanging out with us. And right from then, we knew that like he was going to be one of our best friends here. And we didn't even really know what he was going to be like on the baseball field until we got in the fall, and then he just kind of blew us away. And the thing is, he's gotten better every year, which has been impressive because, you know, each year you think, well, this is as good as it's going to get. He's completely just, you know, been awesome for us this year. And then the next year he goes and he does something better.
He's probably, we were talking about the other day, me and Mike, is he's probably the best player I've ever played with. Like, Mike brought it up, and I kind of don't see any reason why he wouldn't be. You know, he's like, it's crazy that he just started hitting this year, and, like, he's killing it. Because
he's been, like, the best player here for 3 years, like, pretty much without question. He was all conference. This is his third year in a row. He's been dominant. Anytime he pitches, we pretty much have a chance to win against anyone. Yet, at the same time, he's never once called me out in a negative way, made me feel less than him. If anything, he's made me feel better than probably what I am. And I think he does that for a lot of people.
He's a phenomenal player, and it's because he's a phenomenal person. Ryan Kaveney is a workhorse. He's the most positive person I know. He's also the quietest person I know and the weirdest person I know. All of that adds up to just like him just being himself. Like, Ryan is himself, and he loves baseball.
He is probably the best player ever at Beloit. Like, he's not only the best pitcher, but he's been a great hitter. I mean, and he has the walk-off hit against Norbert, of course. Like, you know, I remember I was standing next to Miz, and Ryan comes up to the plate, and he's like, who else is going to come up for the plate right now with two outs? You know? And it's just like, he just cemented his legacy as a Beloit legend.
Made a lot of, you know, pretty good friends here, and you know, I wouldn't trade the people I've met here for just about anything.
It doesn't mean anything if it's yours.
You'd be surprised. Who knows my DNA? Stop trying to blast it.
Bitch.
Yeah, that's what you get.
We're just a fighter, I'll tell you that. Tears of joy stream down my face.